Shalom, shalom. From the quarantine of my house, I greet you with the peace of Christ in the name of the one who was risen from the dead, Jesus, the Prince of Peace. Every time I start teaching anywhere when I'm invited, I like to teach on the word shalom. I do it very intentionally. I like to greet people with shalom, understanding what that word really means. Hebrew is very peculiar in the way every word has an actual meaning and every name has a meaning. Say, my name would have a meaning. And every letter in the Hebrew also has a particular meaning. So when you get the four letters of the word shalom, shin, lamed, vav, mem, when you put together the meaning of those letters, you get a phrase which really nicely explains the meaning of shalom. So here's the word picture. Shalom is the destruction of all authority that establishes chaos. Wow, let me say that again. Shalom is the destruction of all authority that establishes chaos. So if there is chaos in the world, when we decree shalom, we bring on a spiritual warfare to destroy that chaos, to destroy any entities, demonic entities, that are bringing upon that chaos into that house, that family. Now, we have the peace of God. We see that in John 14, 27. The Lord Jesus says, "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. Not as the world gives do I give you. Do not let your heart be troubled, nor let it be fearful." He gives us his peace. It's the peace that surpasses all understanding. It has to be completely different from the peace that we see and we have in the world. Now, we spoke about this yesterday when we read Matthew 24, portions of Matthew 24. Jesus was saying there were going to be wars and rumors of wars. He was saying nation would rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom. Various places would have famines and earthquakes. In Luke, we saw there would be pestilence. So what are we supposed to do with this? And he says very clearly in verse 6, "See that you are not frightened. See that you are not fearful. Do not be afraid, for I am with you. I am your God. Nothing that can be shaken will be shaken. If you are in me, you have the aspect of eternity to hang on to. And I am your tabernacle, and you are my tabernacle. He lives in us, and we live in him. And he is the Prince of Peace. He has given us that peace. We need to start living from what we have within us, because we live in a particular place, and we live in the kingdom of God. And that's what needs to transbordar. That is Portuguese. It's what needs to, I forget the word now, but you know what I mean. It needs to from you, ooze from you, the peace of God. When Jesus sent the 70 in Luke 10, and when he sent his 12, Matthew 10, he gives them the same instruction. He says, guys, when you go into a house, you say, my peace, peace be in this house. And then in Luke 10, he says, if it's not well received, bring it back. Take it back upon yourself. Why is he doing that? Because people need to know the difference between having peace of Christ and the peace of the world. And this is great for people to know they really do need God. And when you preach the gospel, you can't just say, oh, maybe you need God. No, you don't. You do absolutely need God. There's no way you're going to make it without Jesus. Jesus is the way to the Father. He's the only way to the Father. He's the way, the truth, and the life. And there's nowhere we're going in eternity that is any good without Jesus. And he is the Prince of Peace. So he's going to help us navigate this. He's going to help us endure until the end, verse 13 of Matthew 24. And we will be saved because of his peace. Now, be intentional when you're praying for your city, for your nation, for the people, for anyone you're meeting in the streets. When you say shalom, understand what you are saying. You are bringing down the entities that are causing chaos in this world. Be the bearer of good news and the transmitting person, the transmitter of shalom. And may the peace of God be upon you and all your loved ones and in your house and in your nation. B'Shem Yeshua, the Messiah, the Christ. Amen. Love you guys. Shalom. Shalom.